Hello, I'm Rod Gemayel, curator of Allandale Mansion. Please join me as we take a quick tour. Allandale was built by a gentleman by the name of Harvey Brooks. Harvey moved here to Kingsport in 1913 from Rogersville along with his brother. They started out doing just rough cut lumber, cutting down trees. Probably a lot of the old barns in this area were made from lumber that they had sold. Although Harvey was a very astute businessman, his true passion in life were raising Black Angus cattle and Tennessee walking horses. He had a home in East Kingsport, a farm in East Kingsport, which was going to be going underwater when they were building Fort Patrick Henry Dam. Therefore, he needed to find a new location to move his stock to. After World War II, he purchased the grounds here, which was 500 acres, from J. Fred Johnson. At that point, there were several barns on the campus here, along with two ponds. And a building that was built in 1852 that was owned by the Netherland family. We call that the Brown House because it was later owned by the Brown family. Mr. and Mrs. Brooks met with Alan Dryden Sr., who was the architect on this home. And at that time, Mrs. Brooks told him, she said all she wanted was a little white farmhouse with a white picket fence. And then in the next breath, she said, and I don't mean 9-foot ceilings. I want 12-foot ceilings upstairs and down. And with that, Mr. Dryden knew that his idea from an architectural point of view and her idea of what a little white farmhouse was from a consumer's point of view were two entirely different things. What Mr. Dryden eventually ended up designing was the classical Georgian style home. A Georgian style home is typified by having it's a two-story building, a two-story home, having large foyers on both the first and second floor, and those floors are connected on the corners by four large rooms. And that's what we have here at Allandale. The room we're currently in is the parlor. This is kind of a place where we have a lot of gatherings during events. Wedding cakes are cut here. The first toast of the bride and groom are in this room. We have dinners. Sometimes people will sit in here. This is also a room in which we have our grand piano here that you see. Also in this home you would see this is called a Hunt mantle. The Hunt brothers in the 1800s had a craft of making mantles. Today we don't think about that as a craft that somebody would focus on, but back in the 1800s that's what the Hunt brothers were known for. Mr. Brooks had collected these mantles during a period of time, and when he built this house, he had them incorporated into the home. Behind me, you'll see the Dutch china cabinet, which has silver and crystal place settings that were owned by the Brooks. As you go through the home, I'd like to point out that probably 95% of what's at Allandale right now, the artwork, the carpets, the antiques, the china, or original to the home. One of the main features of the mansion that you'll notice is the grand staircase that I'm standing on. This, along with the front portico, were moved to Allandale from the old Adkins Mansion in Knoxville after World War II. Mr. Brooks was one of these guys who did not take no for an answer, and he knew if he wanted to do something, you might as well not argue with him, go ahead and figure out how to do it. At that time, the Adkins Mansion was being torn down, and Mr. Brooks wanted to purchase and move to Kingsport the front portico along with this grand staircase that I'm standing on. He had to get permission from the state. It took three flatbed trailer trucks. It took a highway patrol escort. There were some bridges between here and Knoxville that all of this would not go under. Therefore, he had to pay some farmers to tear down their fences, pull the trailers up and over down the other side and rebuild those fences. But that was something he was interested in doing. He liked it. He wanted to have it in his home. The front portico and staircase were stored in a tin building on the piece of property here for several years prior to the construction of the mansion. We're in the bedroom of the master suite side of the mansion. The beds that you see that I'm standing between were beds that Mrs. Brooks saw a picture of some beds in House Beautiful magazine. It had a little short half canopy that you see. She liked the beds. She tore a picture out of the magazine. Mr. Brooks in turn mailed it to a friend of his who owned a furniture company in Kentucky. And from that photograph, he constructed these two one-of-a-kind beds for Mrs. Brooks. Here in the library, we use this large antique table for some small business meetings. Now, when the Brooks lived here, that table was not here. In this room, you would find, in addition to the wonderful library which housed their books that they loved to read, you would also find their small black and white TV and their hi-fi set. This is where they spent a lot of their personal time together in the evenings. I'd like to thank you for joining me on the tour of Allandale Mansion. If you're interested in renting the facility for a function of just about any kind or tour in Allandale, if you'd give us a call at 229-9422 or visit our webpage, we would love to help you.